for the Satira Bill, formerly known as Trabajo Bill, moves to the Senate after the lower house last week approved on third and final reading the bill that's supposed to lower corporate income taxes while rationalizing fiscal incentives. The vote, 178-6. This morning on Matters of Fact, the champion of the president's tax reform agenda in the lower house joins us, House Ways and Means Committee Chairman Joey Salceda. Good morning, Congressman Joey. Thank you so much for joining us. So is it still a battle? I mean, you've got a highly popular president, supermajority in the lower house and at the Senate. Is it a sure-in?
What's the 24? Mm-hmm. They have 20 there. Uh-huh. The 30 super coalition. Mm-hmm. What, saan napunta yung 12-0, which is historic because you never get a midterm sweep by any president in history. So I'm sure that the president will use his political, but this is the best investment of his political capital.
Do you see any road bumps ahead?
Of course, there is.
What would those road bumps be?
Of course, yung mga nasanay po sa easy money, lalong-lalo na po sa mga, sa ati pong mga nagbe-benefit po sa mga incentives.
So I wanted to go over very quickly, sir, what were the key differences dun sa House version that you guys passed last week versus yung version submitted during the 17th Congress, which didn't make?
Dati kasi 3-2-2. Mm-hmm. Ngayon po, meron na po tayong essentially, pag NCR ka, 3-2. Pag NCR adjacent, 4-3. So essentially, from 5 years, in-extend namin ng 10 years, mm-hmm. if you invest in the countryside. Mm-hmm. So 6 years ITHs and 4 years of reduced investment. Mm-hmm. Tapos meron doon no max on reapplication. Mm-hmm. Pangatlo, almost covered ng SIPP ang 64% ng lahat po ng mga gross value added. Mm-hmm. Tapos may switching provision doon. In fact, pag pinag-aralan nila itong law o yung bill, there is more, lalo-lalo na kung ang natitira sa iyo sa sunset provision. We retain the sunset provision at 532. Uh-huh. So, mahalata mo dito, I was trying to change it.
Okay.
So, 5, kung less than 10, 3, and 2. Mm-hmm. So, there was an effort to extend it, but the DOF said no. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Are you happy then, with the version?
Oh, yeah. It's actually, it is a very, parang promo program siya eh.
Uh-huh.
Kasi pag tiningnan mo, yung after 6 years, di ba, may ITH ka. Mm-hmm. So, bawa, kung nasa province ka, so by the time na you will be under the reduced corporate income tax, 5 years ka, di ba, nag-transit ka, mm-hmm. ang babayaran mo, 13% na lang. Oh. So, 18, 17, 16, 15, 13. Nawala yung dulo, yung 13. Eh, ang 13 is equal to your gross income earned, 5% gross income earned, kasi hindi lahat na di-deduct on. Samantalang dito, ano ba yung mga deductibles? Ito, 100%. 100% for research, 100% more for labor, 50% more for labor, 100% more for infrastructure, 50% more for reinvestment, 50% more for domestic input. Mm-hmm. So, pang bumili ka. So, ang kinaibahan lang naman, dalawa, walang forever, pangalawa, wala ng GIE. Mm-hmm. Kasi nakita namin ang GIE is a very perverse. Gross income earned. Kasi pag nakita mo to, ito po yung mga kumpanya na nasa loob ng zone. Ito yung orange na to. Uh-huh. Other expansion. Makita mo, same company, kasi tinignan namin yung buong universe of people na mayroong company dito, company dun sa labas. Ay, marami po yan. Siyempre, mayaman eh. So, makikita mo na tinatransit nila. It is under the BEC, which is called the basic base earnings, base erosion, and profit shifting. Sinishift nila doon kasi dito may tax shield, dito wala. Walang pakinabang. So, magkano inabot? 64 billion. Oh, inabot po noong 2016. Latest figure ng transfer pricing anomaly.
Uh-huh.
So, definitely there will be no GIE and CIT together. It is the mother of all transfer pricing anomalies. So, wala ka namang ginagawa. You don't earn it except that there is another another framework we call CIT. So, kaya ang pangatlo, obviously, dati hindi nakalink sa performance. Naalala mo, sinabi ko na under the SIT, the reduced CIT, mapapakinabangan mo lang yun pag, pag nag-invest ka dun sa
research and development, rest, for example.
Ngayon, wala naman yan dyan eh. Diba? Wala naman yan dyan eh. So, paano mo nasabi na, so, afterthought lang na may jobs. Pwede kang invest na invest. Kaya, but we are now particular that you create job, you buy from Albay, you don't buy abroad. So, there will
kumbaga
be...
Kumbaga may specific benchmark na.
Oh, ay di. Conditional ang incentives mo. Depende sa kung anong ginawa mo.
When you do the math, Congressman Joey, when you look at the universe...
Walang, sabi ko sa BPO, ni piso, walang mawawala sa kanila.
Really? They'll get more incentives?
Walang mawawala. Lalo-lalo na pag lalo sila mag-hire.
What about the manufacturers?
Yung manufacturer, it's same. It's a, may reinvestment para sa kanila lang pag nilagay sa manufacturing. So, halimbawa, kumita ka ng 100 million last year, ni-reinvest mo sa manufacturing din. Yung buong 100 plus 50%. Deductible.
But why do they feel, Congressman Joey, na this looks good on paper? It's very 2D.
Alin?
Pero when you look at yung sitira,
oh, I'm 2D Albay.
But when you look at, it works like 3D, and the third dimension is reality. And the reality is, the foreign companies are shying away from expanding here or coming here. It happened to Samsung. Lately, it happened to GM as well.
Well, of course, we will make our best shot for competing there. Kasi hindi mo naman malalahat yan. May mga appetite for risk sila. May mga ano sila. Pero at the same time, sinasagot natin, hindi po pwede sagot ang incentive sa mga kailangan ng Samsung. Pero meron kami special provision doon, giving the president authority to give land, to give anything, to compete for basically anything under the sun. Ngayon, dahil sobrang, ano yun, ito yung total investment natin, itong itim. Itong pula.
Pesa.
Pesa. Ano bang pinag-iinarte nila? This is approvals by Pesa. Ito ang BOI. It's not the point. The bulk over the past 3 years of the 10 billion per year is no longer pesa. So, di naman sila pumapasok dito for incentives. There must be something good we're doing right now, the investment in infrastructure. Of course, with a willful president. You know, when I was in the stock market, I always tell my analysts, if you want to pick stock, simple, look at management, good produce result. Don't saka na yung financials. Sa pricing na lang yan. But sabi ko, there's no such thing as a good price for a bad company. The Philippines is a good company.
And what do we have going for us, Congressman Joey?
Oh, of course, the demographic dividend. Our fertility rate is 3.1%, effectively extending our demographic sweet spot by 25 years.
But the power prices here are 30% higher, logistics at least 10% higher.
That's why I think essentially, yung typology ng mga companies that are invited here will essentially be on the service sector because they use very less electricity. In fact, yung ating pong energy intensity has actually been coming down. Ito kasi yung mga kasalanan ni Marcos na ipon, yung mga kasalanan ni ng IPP ng 1992. At pati itong pesa, pinanganak to 95. Kumbaga sa ano, binigay natin ang lahat sa kanila para lang makuha yung ating fair share.
So
that is why you gave 5% gross income earned forever with no relationship. Tingnan mo yung kanilang ano. Oh, eto. Yung incentives na ibigay natin sa kanila, 5.4 trillion. Magkano lang yung investment nila? Approved, 3.6 trillion. Eh dahil ito, pag pinush mo to current prices, ang naibigay natin sa kanila, 14 trillion in incentives. Magkano yung approving na? Similar basis, 8 trillion.
So, lugi pa.
6 trillion. Sino nagsasabi na it's free? It's very expensive. Those pesa investments are very expensive, economically costly. So, baka umalis sila. Ang tingin ko, di ma, muna-una, mayroon tayong adjustment period, yung 532. Sinubukan kong ang gawing mas extend. Kaso doon mga galing ang pera, pambayad ng corporate income tax reduction.
Yes.
Ito, yung pero next na yan.
Uh-huh.
So, see, I think this chart says it all. Despite what you call higher prices, etc., it's more about we're trying to ease of doing business. I think we need to really crack on all the LGUs. Uh-huh. Dapat you should copy Legaspi one day, all registration, labas.
What do
I
you
think, especially in Metro Manila, is and policy predictability, commitment uh-huh. to ano. Meron pa sana isang chart di ko nadala, but that is the chart for Public Service Amendment Act. Kasi, pag tiningnan mo yung ating pong reforms, well, pasensya na ka. Alcohol income, alcohol excise tax, 34 billion. Citira, approve on third. Pipita, approve on third. FIE, approve on third. PSA amendment, now on second. New PP law, in the committee being reviewed. National Evaluation Service, going into the plenary. Mabilis ngayon po ang reforms. Mm-hmm. So I think they're looking for the reform. It's pretty much important.
Congressman, what do you make of PEZA? It seems like PEZA's been very passionate and a vocal critic of certain provisions of Citira.
Like
the rationalization of fiscal incentives.
So okay
what
lang,
do you make, sir, of...
Okay lang ba malugi tayo ng 14 trillion? Mm-hmm. Okay lang ba yun? Tapos ang linagay nila, 8 trillion lang?
Have you talked to Director General?
Pinatawag siya namin sa committee. But apparently, kasi obviously, ang position ko dyan, they should settle it inside the cabinet. It is a member of the team of the president. So why should I be rejecting DTI, rejecting PESA? It's not my job. Mm-hmm. So, sinabi ni Presidente, in-approve to noong January 8, 2018. 2 years na. Ilang beses na in-approve sa Congress. Twice. So, hindi pa ba sapat yung klase ng deliberation? Almost every day, morning breakfast ko, stakeholders, lunch ko, stakeholders, pagdating sa hearing, stakeholders, every day in, day out, just answering all these questions. MBC, JFC, JP, ITB Pop, name it, PCCI. So, I think we must have heard them already. And I think... Citira is good for our country. It is the right thing to do, even for the sake of fairness. So, bibigyan mo sila ng ganun last year, hindi nominal to, dahil sa TIMTA, nabibilang na namin kung magkano talaga yung binibigay natin sa kanila, 604 billion. Samantala, pinipeste natin yung mga 1 million SMEs who had to come up with the same 600 billion in corporate income tax. How fair is that? 90% ng lahat ng jobs nandun sa SMEs. Ang mga RBEs o Registered Business Enterprise, like PESA, 686,000.
I asked that question to a foreign company congressman and they said that...
Have they been growing?
And the response is, but foreign companies have a choice. We can always move out.
We also have a choice.
SMEs
a national will. National will. Where will you find the single biggest pool of the most young and mobile professionals? Mm-hmm. Where do you find that? That's why you cannot even deploy it inside, we deploy it outside. And where do you find a social culturally predisposed to Western culture? Mm-hmm. Oh my God, I don't know when will China and the other rest will be able to speak fluent English. Mm-hmm. No accent. That's a nice thing about the Filipinos. They have no accent.
Congressman, before we move on to the other topics, there's news, rumors, that there was a female economic manager who's going to get booted out.
I don't want to be blamed for it.
Is it going to be PESA?
I did not make that recommendation.
But it is confirmed.
Going for that. How much are we paying for each worker inside the zone? ITBPO, 14,000 per year. SAPI, all SAPI, all PESA, 459,000, 460,000 per year.
This is per job.
And then sa PESA, 186, but that includes ITBPO. So you just look at this one. Sino ba yung mga maingay? Aba, ang country natin to. And them, they also, if they have duty to their stakeholders, they have duty to this country also. And this is based on principles. Very fair, that it should be fair, equitable, efficient, and effective. And of course, in consonance to the national goal. So, ito kasi merong ani, merong not dichotomy, but rather, there is this, wala nang relationship sa performance, yung mga incentives ngayon eh. Are you producing more jobs? Pag pagdating nila sa BOI, nasa tabi nyo lang eh, o PESA, hindi naman nilagay doon. They make a promise they will create more jobs, etc. Diba? So, pero yung incentive ba nakalink sa jobs? Hindi. Eto, you want more incentives, reduce more jobs. You want more incentive, buy from Albay. You want more incentive, train your workers. 100% more deduction. You want to more incentives? Then invest in roads leading to your factory. You want more incentives? Then invest in R&D. So in other words, clear, these are our these are the elements, ingredients towards our national goal.
Congressman Joey, final question on PEZA. Do you think DG Plaza is going to get booted out because of this?
Come again, I don't want to be blamed for it.
Okay.
But she is a member of the team, economic team of the president.
Is she the only female member of the economic team?
There are many. Yung SBMA.
Okay.
But I asked her already, si Esma. Say, maganda yung news doon eh. May mag-i-invest ng 1 billion to take over Hanjin. Since there are exclusivity talks na. And it's an American firm.
Wow.
And for an Australian, basically. So, and in September 5, no. In, I think, the 15th, we are breaking ground. FedEx is back to Clark.
Good news.
Who said that it's all about incentives? It's all about managing an economy and what is your national goal. And do you exhibit, demonstrate your capacity to execute your national strategy? So, hindi naman ganun kaano tayo. Of course, sabi ko nga, okay, pwede ba? Wala lahat incentive. Ilagay na lang natin lahat to lower power costs. Will it answer the question? Will it? Well, yun ang lagi sinasabi nila. Pag tiningnan mo naman yung kanilang top 5 concern, wala naman dun. Number one is policy predictability or ease of doing business. Mm-hmm. Number two is infrastructure. Of course, infrastructure may include power costs and of course, internet speed and cost. And of course, the presence of ports, roads, highways, and airports.
Congressman Joey, before you mentioned the Hanjin.
Yes.
What's the timetable for that?
I think they're close.
So it's an American company?
Oh, definitely it's an American company.
Okay. What else can you share about that?
I don't know. I don't know, but I think it's Severus.
Okay.
And essentially a private fund. But of course, it's dealing for somebody. Mm-hmm. An Australian shipbuilding company.
Mm-hmm. Are we
Remember, they have 62 more years in SBMA, leasehold. So that is what is being bought there. 62 years. I don't know how many thousand, 200 hectares? Just think of what you can do with 62.
But we'll do the same business.
I don't know. But definitely, mayroon dating 33,000 workers, ngayon 3,000. O ngayon, pag ganyan, binigay mo lahat ng incentives. So, sagot ba ng incentives ang business cycles? 12 years pa lang yun. 33,000. Bumagsak ng 3,000 workers. So, hindi masasagot lahat ng incentives.
Congressman, this year, within this year, this deal will
be
closed?
There are exclusivity talks already.
Okay.
Di man yan, ano, kumbaga sa, ano, nag-chat na si Gerald Kibeya.
Okay.
So, that is the moral equivalent of it.
Okay.
So,
Congressman, very quickly on the other issues, rice tarification law. People want it repealed or amended.
Nababoy na mga rice trader eh.
Because the farmers, the farm gate price is at 17 minus production cost of 12.50, giving the farmers a profit margin of 5.50.
Oh,
is that
man.
Decent? Can it compete with imported rice?
Hindi.
So what happens to our farmers?
Kaya kailangan, from the start, kahit ano kasi ganyari yun, it's not just the yield that matters. It's really, you need big farmers to deal with big traders.
Okay.
Kasi pag ini-implement mo ang batas, akala namin pag if you shift the supply curve to the right, it will lead to lower prices and more volume and therefore greater welfare.
Uh-huh.
But instead, we strengthen the bargaining position of the traders over the markets. Binaba lang retail by 5. Pero yung farmers, binaba nila by 20% yung kanilang buying price. Mm-hmm. So itong proposal po ng DA, that's okay. Pero ano yan eh, pantawid lang. At saka hindi namin yan fiscally. That is, fiscally, it is very expensive. Bibili ka at 19, 10, assuming 10% of the annual production of palay, which is 22 million kilos. 22 million niya. 22 million metric tons ang ating palay. Tapos, bibenta mo ng 26, palugi ka ng 8. So, sa capital pa lang, hindi bababa na 53 billion kailangan mo. Eh, kaya nga natin tinanggal yung NFA sa equation. Eh. Kasi, ang NFA, kuminsan, alam mo naman, kahit basa, tinatanggap. So, yung pag nabibenta ng gumbiyan, mas mababa sa yield. Tapos, magbibenta ka na naman ngayon sa 27, lower than the current markets of 32. So, yung lugi, absorb natin, assuming magpakapitalan natin ng 23 yan, ng 53 billion, automatic, lugi ka ng 20. So, saan nakukuha ng taxes para bayaran yan? Eh, yung UHC pa lang, is dinadahan-dahan ko. I think by the end of the year, it will be fully funded, all that 52 billion.
For UHC?
Yes. Number one, the yung alcohol taxes.
Would that be enough?
No. But I'm looking at MBUC adjustment of 91% over 3 years.
Okay.
Since 2004, hindi na gumalaw.
Uh-huh.
Pangatlo, definitely we are studying very, not quietly, but how do you call that? We've been studying, we definitely will reestablish the fiscal regime for mining industry. So I've been talking slowly and quite deliberately with all the stakeholders, mm-hmm. Especially, of course, the advocates.
But there's still a moratorium on mining.
In EO 79, it says nothing unless there is a fiscal regime. My committee is in charge of that fiscal regime.
How soon?
We're studying, and this one we will not be, kasi we want to balance the interest, the national interest of the next generation, but between, of course, the current interest of this generation to gross value added. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that we will do a Peru or Chile where it is 12% of GDP, but definitely where it came from, it was 1% of GDP.
What's the target? What's a decent target?
I am a hard worker. So by the time we come out with a fiscal regime for mining, and it's under Rule 48 also, mm-hmm. lahat na nag-Rule 48, dami po namin ginawa na para pong bago pumasok po ng floor, ay yun na po ay kumbaga na process na nilut, dami pang pinasarap. Ngayon itong mining, careful kami kasi nga we have to balance the needs of our environment and the needs of ito bang mga ginto to should serve also the Filipinos in 60 years from hence. No,
So what's the target? Ilan percent of GDP?
Ah, mining? Balik lang sa 1.
1 pa din?
1, GVA.
Okay.
Pero pagdating sa revenues, yun. I want to make sure that the local government unit have their decent share.
Can we expect
isa ako sa mga sumuporta sa EO 79 kasi wala naman natatanggap yung province doon eh. Sa rapu-rapu. Mm-hmm. Wala naman kasi sa batas eh.
Mm-hmm.
So, kailangan natin ibalik niya. For the sake of the host communities, I think definitely, kung hindi man sa share ng national government kukunin, well, definitely doon sa ano. So, yung pangalawa, yung decommissioning, dapat hindi lang straightforward, kundi monitored. Hindi po pwede na hawak ng pera. Definitely, the escrow fund for decommissioning will be set aside in an independent bank account.
Pero suma total, Congressman Joey, when can we expect the moratorium to be lifted?
Once we pass the fiscal
regime. When is that?
Oh, ikaw talaga binamukha. Tinatrabaho ko po. Ngayon po, after September 20, we have more time after the budget. I'm also tasked to defend all the policy heavy departments and agencies by of course by the speaker. So lahat naman to nasa tempo ni Speaker at saka ni Manjo. We are great, ano, in sync po ang House. Mm-hmm. So, napakaganda po ang reform-mindedness ng
next year,
members.
Congressman,
Alan,
you'll get this done next
Senate
year.
Senate kasi, pero sa House.
But it's super majority.
Pero sa House, November.
November?
Hindi ako magbo-birthday. October 26, wala ako kung ano.
Okay.
So we're doing that and I'm studying all the other options. Yung MBUC, baka half.
Okay.
Kasi sa ngayon po, pumapasok na siya sa national fund, mm-hmm. sa GF, general fund. So, baka half dahil po sa impact ng traffic, impact po ng mga kotse, and the environment. Baka half, iligay ko rin po sa universal health care.
Okay.
So, sinasabi ko sa iyo, I will fully fund the $52 billion. There's a single-minded goal. There's one goal, one solitary goal that we are pursuing single-mindedly is to fund the UHC. Yes. And I hope that the DOH and the PhilHealth, they all behave because they should not undermine my capacity, the forbearance of ordinary Filipinos for pain, for the sake of the health goals. So, importante po sa akin. I've been talking now all now to the Duque. I've talked to PhilHealth President. I said, you make sure that you provide me with the ecosystem that will, of course, be more inducive, conducive to the passage of all these tax measures. Everything for health.
Okay, we don't have much time. Last two questions, big issues. Oil, the attack on Saudi Aramco. Are you looking at subsidies? Can we be open to subsidizing?
Come again?
Oil prices expected to jump.
Naman po, nasa train 1 yung pampasada. So automatic yan. There's
Stop.
Also the conditional, unconditional cash transfer. We have the means. So we have the policy instruments already in place. Yes,
okay.
I think we will definitely consider that. But we will not, of course, subsidize big corporations who have the capacity to essentially underwrite the impacts of the oil. And definitely it will be short term. So why is renewable prices down 80%?
Mm-hmm.
So
okay. And one more, yes. African swine fever. Do we have the budget it's a much bigger problem than it's being reported?
I think I trust Secretary Dar is on top of it. And during the budget hearing, we have talked about the ASF. I'm fully convinced that the DA has faced much greater, yung mga sa chicken nun, yun talaga mas widespread.
Okay.
So dito, I think what we need to have really is a more robust communications program so that the people will know. So,
okay.
And of course, the producers will undertake precautionary or preemptive measures in order to keep our hog production on the level.
Thank you very much, Congressman Joey.
Yes.
Advance happy birthday. We'll get back to you on the
kasi
the bill
walang tao sa Congress kasi alisto kami na October 5 baka agahan pa kasi nga wala nang session. So nobody goes to my birthday. So I asked everyone